Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. According to this countdown device, I have roughly 20 minutes of filming video left on this, which means I need to go through and clean things out. But before we get started, let me just say, this is Scot Albert Hypnotist, a.k.a. Scot Albert Consultant, a.k.a. Scot Albert, the guy who does the strange tarot readings, among other things. And my website is www.xpr3.com. And what I'm doing right now, as we're talking, is I'm shuffling the cards. Things feel a lot, I guess, less rigid and structured. Now I'm just doing this when I do this and not worrying about, am I going to do a 3-card count or a 5-card count or 21 card? It's very freeing. I should probably start pulling out my other card decks, among other things, but, you know, we'll see. So, currently it is 1:22 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, 20 March, the year 2024. So, the cards are now shuffled. Let me say this at the outset. It is my hope that whoever needs to hear this information gets to hear this information. All right? So, that said, let's start with the first card. Brilliant idea. Your idea is finally guided. Please take action to bring your idea to fruition. Personally, that is germane for yours truly. Just in terms of, there are some things that have popped into my head recently. And I am finding myself more or less, taking action on those ideas and putting them into motion. Not the least of which is studying. I'm not against reading anything. As a matter of fact, I generally like reading. But I think it's just going to make my life easier in terms of studying all the stuff that I'm studying to have the electronic version do the audio playback and read it to me. That way I can just, you know, watch the words and relax and not get so stressed. So that's one. Two, and this is completely unrelated, but a day or two back, I went to the hospital. Not in any danger, it was just a follow-up on my blood pressure. Which, by the way, is back to textbook. Yay. And I had mentioned, I guess, on a previous visit that, you know, I want to have these ears of mine looked at because it just felt a little off. And as it turns out, my suspicion and hunch was right about needing to have them cleaned professionally. Because the doc took a look inside and said, yep, that left ear is certainly impacted. It's like, really? But I washed my ears. Like, it just happened. It's like, okay. So they started off just, you know, getting out little bits of it. But by the time they were done, they had pulled out something that was about as long as the last digit, the distal digit of my hanky finger, and oof, maybe about an eighth inch around. It's like, but I clean my ears, I swear. So, the good idea I had about my concern over my hearing, not so much I felt like I was losing it, but in terms of just having it checked out or looked into, was correct. Now, it's interesting that the way I'm holding the cards, you can see this last one, so I'm going to pull this next. And it's inverted. And it says, hello from heaven. Archangel Azrael, your loved ones in heaven are doing fine. Let go of worries and feel their loving blessings. Now, this card was inverted. Which, again, as I've mentioned in the past, when I do cards, I tend to pay attention. But when I have an inverted card, that's really important. And I have been thinking about members of my family, you know, who have crossed the Rainbow Bridge, they're in heaven, not the least of which was at the hospital. I walk past this security guard who was, you know, if I didn't give it a closer look, he was a dead ringer for my brother Raymond. And whenever I have that happen, I think to myself, well, they've got to be thinking about me. And among us, I would qualify Raymond as the academic. I'm getting there. Just took a very much multiple decade longer time to get there. But there are things that he told me, taught me, coming up, and one of them is that two wrongs don't make a right. So if you're out there listening, and you're feeling as though someone has wronged you and you'd like to go give them a piece of your mind at the end of a 2x4 or something, don't do it. Better off trusting in karma. Better off not picking up that handgun that you have stashed away, or that baseball bat, or anything else of that nature. People do what they do, and many times it's not necessarily right. But that doesn't mean that you should return their favor and their kindness by doing something comparable. Okay? Two wrongs don't make a right. Remember that. Okay, now, back to the cards. Gut's telling me cut. An inverted card. Prosperity. Well, this is personally germane to me. Archangel Ariel. Your material needs are being provided as you follow your intuition and manifest your dreams into reality. So, here's the card. I hope you can read it. I don't know how many of us do and don't struggle with the whole prosperity thing. Certainly, it's been an issue for yours truly for a long time. But there's a roof over our head. There's food in the fridge. There's food in the cabinets. Cats are fed. Got clean litter. Give them fresh water a couple times a day. They're handled. We're handled. You know, so we're good. But in my mind, prosperity isn't just about money. It's about health. It's about how you feel. Pardon me. And if more times than not, you feel good, you're okay, you're not sneezing your lungs out or coughing your lungs out, you're good. You know, I mean, wear your mask, wash your hands. Watch when what you contact, because you don't know what's carrying this blasted COVID nastiness around here, and you don't, frankly, I don't think you want to get it. So, the thought is to cut the deck again, which I've just done, and I'll pull up another card. This card, all is well. Archangel Jeremiel, everything is happening exactly as it's supposed to. With hidden blessings, you will soon understand. So, whoops. So I feel like I should probably do something with that next card I accidentally pulled up. I think in life there's definitely a tendency for us to worry about things we shouldn't. Worry too much. Overthink things. Probably not in anybody's best interest. Especially yours. Because what does all that energy do for you? Goose eggs, baby. Goose eggs. So, it's difficult to not do it. You know, we all have that tendency to worry about things. Don't. And I'm going to pull this as the last card for this reading. And this is... Oops. Get that angled over. That's better. Chakra Cleaning. Now, some of you know about chakras and some of you don't. Let me give you the Reader's Digest condensed Cliff Notes version of my understanding. We are, among other things, beings of energy. And in those energy fields that surprise us. We have energy sensors. The majority of them are acupuncture or acupressure points, but and that's from the Chinese tradition. From the East Indian tradition, we have chakras. Each one of those chakras has a certain connection and influence on certain places in our being, our body. So if you've got a locked up throat chakra, you might have a tendency to have difficulty expressing yourself. Got a blocked third eye chakra, you might find yourself either unable or unwilling to see the things that literally are right in front of you, and that you should. And it's not a matter of just visual seeing, it's a matter of seeing with your spiritual eye, if you will. So, the ways to clear your chakras. Well, I'll put that in your personal do this as homework assignment box, okay? Google how to clear your chakras, and there's all kinds of methods out there. But I think the point and the message of that last card for this reading was the idea that for your own personal benefit, find a way to clean out your chakras. It's just good to do. It's good. Consider good energetic maintenance. Okay? So, that's the reading. I hope that my story about getting my ear cleaned out didn't gross anybody out, and if it did, I can't exactly apologize. You know, it's life, you know? Every now and then you gotta clean your snot locker, your ears, other body parts. I'll not go too far with that. Just don't want to gross you out more. So, that's it. This has been Scot Albert Consultant, a.k.a. Scot Albert Hypnotist. And the website is www.xpr3.com. Again, I hope that whoever needed to hear this information got to hear this information or will do so. And I hope it does you some good. So please be careful. Be safe out there. I wish you all wellness. Namaste.